أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته الحمد لله We thank and we praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى for granting us the great benefits and the great miracles, great favors of life, health, and well-being, alhamdulillah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us to see the rest of this month of Ramadan through with the highest of iman and taqwa, ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Today, inshallah, we will come to focus on Surah An-Nas, the surah that follows Surah Al-Falaq, which we did yesterday, alhamdulillah. And this surah is part of the Mu'awwidhatayn, the two surah, wherein we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection. And we have discussed yesterday the sabab nuzul, the reason for its revelation, alhamdulillah. Today, to understand Surah An-Nas, we will hear the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس Say, I seek protection in the Lord of mankind. ملك الناس The Lord of mankind. إله الناس The God of mankind. من شر الوسواس الخناس From the evil of the one who whispers and repeats it often. الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي سُدُورِ النَّاسِ From the whisperings into the chest of mankind. مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ When he whispers to jinn and mankind. Subhanallah, Jamaatul Muslimin. This surah speaks about what we seek protection of is the whispers of shaitan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts this surah with, as we have discussed the concept yesterday, the musta'ad bihi and musta'ad minhu, who we seek protection from and what we seek protection from. So who we seek protection from is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're seeking our protection in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here, as our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, that when we appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the most humble manner. This surah, in its essence, is a dua. It's an appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, that when you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then praise Him and glorify Him. In so doing, we say in the surah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself teaches us, by calling Allah on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his attributes. We call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Lord of mankind, the God of mankind. We call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the King of mankind. And this surah teaches us how we should call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any form, then let us call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with humility. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as narrated in Sahih Bukhari, once came upon a man who was appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah grant me such and Allah grant me such. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that this man is hasty in his dua. The companions asked him, Ya Rasulullah, how should we make dua? And he says, first, praise Allah and glorify Him. So here we are taught the adab of appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, appealing to Him for His help, appealing to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala for His protection, appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all our needs. And our greatest need is for protection from the whisperings of shaitan. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي سُدُورِ النَّاسِ That this shaitan, he whispers into the chest, into the hearts of mankind. He whispers into the hearts of people. And he gives us subtle influences. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us Our glorious Lord, our most merciful Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah A'raf, فَوَسْوَسَ لَهُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ, that the shaitan, he whispered to Sayyidina Adam and Sayyidina Hawa alayhima salatu wassalam, by trying to tell them to eat from the tree that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forbidden them. And just similarly, we will find shaitan, he whispers to all of us to do evil. He will come regularly. الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ, he constantly comes to whisper in our ears and tell us to do haram. And that is why we recite this surah, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection from shaitan. When he whispers into our hearts, into our ears, into our minds, to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the greatest thing we should seek protection from. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Ibrahim, Iblis, shaitan, he comes and he whispers to us so often. But on the day of Qiyamah, he will say to us, فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ, don't blame me. On the day of judgment, when so many will say, but the shaitan, he whispered to me and he inspired me to do the haram. He will say to us, فَلَا تَلُومُونِي, don't blame me. وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ, blame yourself. Blame yourselves, subhanAllah. On that day we will come to see that he had betrayed all those who followed him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us through these verses of Surah An-Nas to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly for his help in being protected from the shaitan, being protected from the actions of shaitan, and being protected from all the whisperings of shaitan. If we were to combine these two surah, Surah Al-Falaq and Surah An-Nas, and put them together, these two, as our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, these two are a protection for each and every one who recites it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us in the rest of our lives, that we constantly be upon the sunnah of our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we recite of this Quran and that we imbibe it to the best of our abilities, and inshallah that we end our lives upon the kalima of la ilaha illallah. There is no deity, none worthy of our worship, none worthy of our devotion except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.